Hi everyone, and welcome to our third Biology Daily Booster. You will notice there is a big purple box at the bottom of the screen because this is one of the topics that they did actually tell us will come up on the first biology papers. So Foundation and Higher, Section B1.2, which is part of the work we're covering in today's booster, is guaranteed to have questions on it. So obviously, make sure you know this. But that doesn't mean you can ignore the things not listed on there, because they did have that little caveat on there saying that basically everything's going to be assessed on these papers. But this, we know for sure, will be there. What we're going to be looking at today then is DNA and protein synthesis. So first of all, when we're talking about DNA, this is the genetic material that we find in eukaryotic cells. Now DNA is a polymer. And because we're talking eukaryotic cells, it is found in the nucleus. When we consider how that DNA is actually organized in the nucleus, then what we have are these structures called chromosomes. And then those chromosomes are divided up into little smaller sections called genes. When we're thinking about DNA, one thing that we can say is that everyone has unique DNA. There is one exception. And that is in the case of identical twins. So if you are an identical twin, you are not unique, I'm afraid. You have an identical copy. Everyone else has unique DNA. As we said, genes are short sections of DNA, and the gene itself is going to code for a certain characteristic because it codes for a certain protein. Now, what we'd find is that if all cells made all proteins, there would be no specialization. Instead, different cells switch on and switch off different genes to one another. So some cells will have certain genes switched on, and in a different cell, those same genes would be switched off. That means we have specialized cells. So for example, in a white blood cell, then the genes that we need in order to make antibodies will be switched on, but in your, I don't know, skin cells, they will be switched off. So different cells have different genes switched on or off. When it comes to the structure of DNA, they love this as a question, then DNA is organized in a way called a double helix. So it's a polymer, as we already mentioned, made up of two individual strands that then join together in this very distinctive double helix shape. And you can see it on the right there. Now, each of those strands is made up of units called monomers, because a polymer is made of monomers. And the monomers in DNA are called nucleotides. The nucleotide itself, you can see in the bottom right here, that's our little block diagram of it, has a phosphate, a sugar, which in this case is deoxyribose, and a base. Now, that base takes one of four types in DNA. It will be adenine, thymine, cytosine, or guanine. A, T, C, or G. The reason those bases are important is because they're going to hold the structure of the double helix together. And they do this through complementary base pairing. And by complementary base pairing, we mean that they join in specific pairs. So A always joins with T, and C always joins with G. So pointy letters go together and curly letters go together. A and T, C and G. And that's complementary base pairing that holds the two strands of DNA together to make the double helix. For those of you doing higher tier, you are going to need to know about how we make proteins, or the process of protein synthesis. Protein synthesis is a two-stage process, and we're going to look at each stage in turn. So first of all, we have transcription. So what happens in transcription is the DNA in that particular gene unzips, and that means we've got exposed bases. We've broken those complementary base pairs apart and they're now exposed. Free RNA bases are going to come in and pair up with their complementary base pairs. Now, we do have one little change here. Because we're talking about RNA, then we don't have all the same bases as we do in DNA. There is no thymine or T. So that means on our DNA template, any A's, so any adenines, will pair with uracil or U. All the others are the same. So what we can see, we've got adenine, guanine and cytosine, so A, G and C, but no thymine, it's replaced by uracil. What happens is we actually go all the way along that gene, creating our little strand of RNA, which is actually called messenger RNA or mRNA. Once we get to the end, that little strand of mRNA is released and it then leaves the nucleus where it travels to a structure in the cytoplasm called a ribosome. So the process of making the mRNA is transcription. If you get asked about what happens here, DNA unzips, usually worth a mark on its own. The free RNA bases make their complementary pairs to make the strand of mRNA, which leaves the nucleus. Step two is translation. So this is taking place in the cytoplasm now. Our mRNA has attached to a ribosome. And what happens is, as that mRNA strand moves through the ribosome, it reads that sequence in threes. Now, those threes are what we refer to as a triplet code. So each little sequence of three bases is a triplet, and each triplet codes for a particular amino acid. Now, what we find is that the way that happens is that on the amino acid, there's this little structure here, this yellowy bit, and that is what we call tRNA or transfer RNA. So those transfer RNA or tRNA molecules have a little three base code at the bottom, and that will be complementary to the one on the mRNA strand. So you can see the one in the blue circle on the right, our mRNA is CGG, so our tRNA code is GCC, it's complementary. And that's attached onto the amino acid arginine. Once it's actually brought that amino acid in, the ribosome slides along to the next triplet, reads that triplet code, and a tRNA molecule brings in the next amino acid that's complementary. And it continues all the way along, joining the amino acids together in this polymer chain. And once it's finished, it releases the polymer and it folds up to make the protein. So translation is where we're reading the mRNA sequence in those triplet codes, joining the complementary amino acid through the use of tRNA. As always, final thing to do for the day is to go and check your knowledge on our quiz. The link is in the description below. And of course, don't forget to come back tomorrow for the next Daily Booster to help boost your knowledge before those exams.